If you're leveraging ServiceNow's visual task boards, you know how handy they can be. But did you know that freeform boards offer an excellent level of flexibility beyond just private tasks? That's right, you're not limited. In this video, we're diving deep into how you can supercharge your freeform boards by adding various task types, like incidents and change requests. We'll cover adding tasks from a list view and from a task form to see how they all come together. Let's navigate to the list of unassigned open incidents. I can see 16 tasks listed in here. Let me apply a filter and only show incidents that are in new state. Now the list is down to 13 tickets. I can choose one, multiple, or all tasks at once, go to the Actions menu, and add them to a visual task board. In this example, you're only provided with a list of freeform boards where you can add these cards to. Let's choose the board that we've just created, and they're automatically added to my board. Let's go back to the board. By default, any tasks added to a freeform board from a list will be automatically added to the first lane of the board. In this example, I can see all tasks are listed under the backlog lane. I can move some of them to the week 2 swim lane that I created. And this is done simply by dragging and dropping the cards. Let me move some of my previously created cards to the next lane. From this view, I can see both incidents and private tasks are listed on this board. I can go on and add other task types. This time, I'm going to add a change request to this board. Let's go to the list of open changes. Open one of the change requests and right-click on the top header. You can see the option to add this particular record to your visual task board. Similar to adding tasks from a list view, you can also add tasks from the form view. And you get this confirmation message that this change request has been added. Let's go back to the board. If you scroll down in the backlog lane of the first swim lane, you can see your change requests already added. Since I've applied a sorting based on creation date, and this is one of the older records, I can see this change is down on my list. When I have sorting applied, I cannot manually reorder cards in the same lane, since it's being automatically done by my sorting criteria. When you're adding other task types, remember not all board members may have the right access to view the cards or get assigned to those cards. And you've probably noticed the close icon on the top right-hand side of the cards, and that's our easy way to archive a card without the need to open the card. Unlike data-driven boards, you can freely move any task types in the lanes. Since changes do not actually make updates to the record itself. So in this case, even if you move our change request to the done lane, it doesn't close the change. It just marks it as done in your board. It still shows as new state on the record and in any new boards that you create. We've already looked into the detailed view of a task in data-driven boards like an incident record. You can do the same with private tasks. Let's try and open a private task through the hyperlinked number. By default, you're taken to the VTB view of the task. There's not much information here apart from the assignment group that you can set up. With the proper access, you are able to switch the view of the form to the default view. And this gives you additional options and the flexibility to add more information and track their progress. For example, change the state, set up a parent record, make someone else as the owner or the assignee of the task, mark it as active or inactive, and easily add short description and description. The good thing about this is you can also see the activity stream and all the changes to this task. So you've seen how easy it is to add different task types to your freeform board, track their progress, and update them on the go. The real power of freeform boards lies in this ability to customize and centralize different work items in one visual space. Feel free to explore further and see how you can make it work for you. That's all for now. See you in the next video.